Hello friends, in this video I am going to solve a problem which was asked in CSIR NET exam, and this is the question from part C, so there might be more than one options correct. So let us see what is the problem. So the problem is given that we have given a function f of xy which is equal to 1 minus cos of x plus y upon x square plus y square if xy is not equal to the origin, and at the origin f of 0 0 is half, and similarly we have given g of xy which is defined like this, and we need to find out at what points function is continuous. So let us talk about the first function which is given. So the function is given like f of xy is equal to 1 minus cos of x plus y upon x square plus y square if xy is not zero, not origin, and equal to 1 upon 2 if xy is equal to 0 comma 0. So if this function is continuous, the limit at 0 0 should exist along all the paths. So I will prove that. So we will prove that f is not continuous at the origin. Note that here except the origin function is continuous everywhere, because the numerator is the difference between the constant function 1 and the cos of x plus y, that is continuous, and the denominator is x square plus y square, that is discontinuous only at the origin. So the except origin this function is continuous everywhere. We just need to check that whether it is continuous at the origin or not. So let us try out this path y is equal to x. So along this path what will happen? So the limit xx goes to 0 0 of f of xx, which is same as limit xx tends to 0 0, 1 minus, so this is cos of x plus x, that will be cos of 2x, upon x square plus x square, that will be 2x square. And this limit, so we know that 1 minus cos of 2x is 2 times sine square x. So this will be just limit xx tends to 0 0 2 times sine square x upon twice x square. So 2 2 will get cancelled, and this is just the limit xx tends to 0 0 just sine x upon x the whole bracket square, and we know that this limit is 1, so the ultimate limit is 1. So the along this path y is equal to x, the limit of f of x y is equal to 1, but if we check but the f of 0 0 was given to be half, and we know that this 1 is not equal to half, which implies f is not continuous at the origin. And also we have observed that the except origin the function is continuous everywhere, just because of this is just the quotient of two continuous functions where the denominator function never vanishes. So that means that we have get that the f is continuous everywhere except at the origin. So this is the correct option, and the first option is also correct. Oh, first option is false because we have shown that it is not continuous at 0, 0. Now we will check that whether this function g is continuous at 0, 0 or not. Now let us check that. So the g of xy is given to be 1 minus cos of x plus y upon x plus y bracket square. So note that earlier it was just x square plus y square. Here it is the square of the bracket. If x plus y is non-zero and which is equal to half if x plus y is equal to 0. Now again, if we observe that this is again a quotient of two continuous functions, and whenever the denominator vanishes, this function, so that is where we need to check that whether function is continuous or not, and everywhere else the function is continuous. So if x plus y is non-zero, so it is clear that the function is continuous. So we will just check that whenever x plus y is 0, at that point this function is zero, this function is continuous or not. So again, let us just simplify it. G of xy, where x plus y is non-zero, what we will get, 1 minus cos of x plus y is just just 2 times sine square of x plus y upon 2 upon the x plus y bracket square. So if we divide it here by 4 and multiply it by 4, this will just be 2 times sine square of x plus y by 2 into 4 times x plus y upon 2 the bracket square. So therefore g of xy will be 1 upon 2 times sine square of x plus y by 2 upon x plus y by 2 bracket square. Now it is easy to find out the limit. So if we take limit x plus y tends to 0 of g of xy, that will be just half times limit x plus y tends to 0, and this will be just sine of x plus y upon 2 upon x plus y by 2 and the whole square, and again we know that this limit is 1, so ultimately the limit is just half. And we also know that the g of g of x plus y, whenever x plus y is 0, g of x plus y is half. So that means the all points where x plus y is 0, at that point we have that the g of x plus y is equal to half, which is the limit of functions at those points, which implies that g of xy is a continuous function, and it is continuous everywhere, continuous function everywhere. Therefore we get that the g is continuous everywhere, so it has to be continuous at 0, 0. So the ultimately the correct options are just 2, 3, and 4, and that's it for now. I hope you like this video. Thanks a lot for watching. Please like, share and subscribe If you find this is useful, and also press that bell icon to get the all updates.